This will be yet another quick guide, and today I will show you how to add a page file to Windows 10. So there also is a feature like this on previous Windows like Windows 8 or 7, but the procedure is a bit different. So why would you do this? This is to improve stability in some applications, especially on systems which have a lower RAM amount like 4 or 8 gigabytes. And this can dramatically improve stability on emulators and maybe other RAM intensive applications. So how to do this? Go to Start. The settings, system, scroll all the way down until you see the about page. Here go to system info. Here go to advanced system settings. Here in advanced, you need to click settings for the performance. Go to advanced again, and here we have virtual memory. So this is basically what it is. You will take some space on your hard drives, and this will be used as virtual RAM. So if the RAM is full, it can dedicate some storage to that. So here click change, and default, it should be at automatic. This isn't what we want because this can get some stability issues, and especially this is an issue with some emulators, so make sure to uncheck this. And now go to a custom size, and I recommend to do this on your fastest drive. So for me, it is on my C disk. Click custom size, and the initial and maximum size should be the same. So if you got like 4 gigabytes, I would recommend a page file of about 20 gigs. And if you have somewhere like 8 gigabytes in your computer, maybe put something like 12 gigabytes. For me, it got 16, so it isn't really necessary, but I'm still going to put 12 gigs in it. So that's 12,000 MB is 1 GB. Copy this, paste it here, and now click set. You can also do this for the D drive if you have one. This isn't required, but it could add some extra memory again. Usually, if you have about 12 gigabytes set up here, you are pretty much good to go. Now, once you press OK, it will say the changes you made require a restart to your computer before they can take effect. So this is what you need to do. You need to head over to here and restart your computer. And that was the guide. I hope you find it useful. If you did, let me know in the comments below. If you have any issues, also ask in the comments on my Discord or other social media. Everything is in the description below, and I'll see you in the next video.